Welcome to Molecular Device Axon Tech Talk webinar. My name is Jeffrey Tan, and I'm the product manager of Axon Electrophysiology Product and Molecular Devices, and I will be your host today. So today, it is my honor of having Dr. Lawrence Friends, who will talk about the use of Axoclamp 98 in her research. Let me introduce Dr. Lawrence Friends to you. She received her doctorate degree from Oberlin's College and her PhD degree from Cornell University. Her background is in ion channel physiology, physiology using Xenopus oocytes as an expression system to characterize properties of different potassium channels, spice forms, and fluorescence imaging of ion channel in situ. She's currently an associate professor and chair of the biology department at Allegheny College, a small liberal arts college in western Pennsylvania that has a strong focus on undergraduate teaching and research. Her main research project has involved in Xenopus oocyte expression system as a way to screen Thomas Winnems for ion channel targeting activity. The topic of her presentation today is using the Axoclamp 98 for 2-electrode voltage clamp of Xenopus oocyte expressed ion channels to characterize Thomas Snell-Winnems actions. So in this webinar, Dr. Lawrence French will focus the techniques of 2-electrode voltage clamp and also focus how to conduct 2-electrode voltage clamp and how to optimize the data analysis with Axoclamp 98, and she also will further discuss the challenge and rewards of teaching undergraduate to do this work. So I want to repeat again, you can submit your question at any time during the webinar in the Q&A boxes, and you just hit the, you know, submit the send button. So before I turn to Dr. French Lawrence, I want to introduce a little bit about the Axoclamp 98. And 98 is an ideal amplifier for 2-electrode voltage clamp and current time recording, for example, for oocyte and a muscle cell. And it is a computer control with two hastily attached. So for the Axoclamp 98, we not only for 2-electrode voltage clamp, we also can do like current clamp and also with the discontinuous current clamp for accurate voltage measurement, and also we also can do discontinuous single electrode voltage clamp for small cell with large current. And you can also use 98 for ion to fluorescence too. So we, in this seminar, we also over the brief saving to all the audience in this webinar. So please contact, if you are in North America, please contact Jackie Flowers. And if you are in Europe, please contact Richard Winter for this brief saving opportunity. Then now I will hand the ball to Dr. Lawrence French.
So we're ready to go then.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for that introduction. It's really a pleasure to be here today. As Jeffrey said, I'm at Allegheny College, which is a four-year liberal arts college. We have 2,100 students. It is all undergraduate. There are no graduate students, and so this presents challenges. And as a faculty member, balancing, we have a lot of, the main emphasis is on teaching. But we also have active research programs here and really try to incorporate the students into our research programs as much as possible, both because this is how you teach people to be real scientists, to make that transition from learning in the classroom from a textbook to doing science, the active part of doing science. How do you ask experimental questions, how do you conduct experiments, analyze them, and communicate your findings? All of that is so vital to science education. And to sort of complement that, Allegheny has a required senior project, which is a year-long independent research project, usually based on a faculty member's area of expertise or, you know, somewhat related. And so especially in the science curricula, we have research built in so that students can learn how to do these things and so that they're prepared for their senior project and beyond. And so incorporating one's own research into courses and other work with students really benefits both the faculty and the students alike. And so as you can see from the title, my main focus is with ion channels and using conus venom. I have a few other projects. But actually today, after I give a little intro to this, as Jeffrey said, the main focus of this talk will be on the sort of the technical aspects of using the Axoclamp equipment and the how, you know, kind of step-by-step how-to instructions. At the end of the talk, I will have my contact information. If anybody has questions for me or wants access to information I talk about, you should feel free to contact me after the webinar. You can also get a hold of information about this presentation through the Molecular Devices website. So cone snails, for people who are not familiar with them, are a predatory genus of snail, which is kind of an odd thing in itself. They're really fascinating. This shows several different views, including for some scale there, the different, there's lovely shells. There are over 700 species of these snails. And they live in the ocean, but they don't swim, and they're snails, so they're rather slow. So at the outset, it's kind of a mystery as to how they could hunt anything that doesn't die on top of them. But they actually make up for these shortcomings by having an incredibly potent venom. Each species has a unique venom that comprises hundreds, if not thousands, of small peptides and other molecules that target nervous system proteins with unmatched specificity. And Dr. Baldomero Oliveira has really pioneered this work in the natural biology of the snails, as well as the biochemistry of the venom and the pharmacological applications of the venom. And I collaborate with his lab on this project. So I use the Xenopus Labus oocyte expression system to express RNA encoding ion channels that I'm interested in and screen those ion channels with conus venom. When we find a venom that affects an ion channel, for example,